Welcome back. You're watching Newsmaker Live with me, Kendal Burton. My guest this evening, Mr. Guy Joseph, Castries Southeast MP, former Works Minister. Before the break, we were talking about the unfamiliar kindness of the SLP towards your former leader of the opposition, Stevenson King. Perhaps suggestions that maybe they're trying to woo him to the other side?
I have said it on several occasions. I have every confidence in the Honorable Stevenson King. Mm-hmm. That he's a loyal UWP and will remain that way. If anything else happens, I will be pleasantly surprised.
But can you say the same about other members of the party? We were talking about the last sitting of parliament at which the Castries central MP made some damning allegations. Though you weren't named, I think a lot of people think it was implied that some of those allegations were leveled at you. How do you respond?
I get the impression from people that this is what they were thinking. Mm-hmm. I was sitting there and I was smiling. Mm-hmm. Because I knew within myself mm-hmm. that the member for Central Castries could not have been referring to me. Mm-hmm. Because the evidence shows different. Because he spoke about asphalt and mining getting an advance payment.
Yeah. Can I quote him directly?
Yeah.
In August 2011, when I was getting ready to be kicked out of cabinet, there was illegality in the government. A company received $2.443 million of taxpayers' money before they had a bobcat or wheelbarrow on the site of the project, sadly, which is yet to be completed.
And that is what I'm saying, mm. that this information is erroneous. Mm. Because in 2011, no company, to my knowledge, had received any payment on any project mm-hmm. as an advance payment. A contract was signed for the Bokal Shabbat Road in 2011. I think to be more precise, I think it was October 13, 2013, or somewhere thereabout. Mm-hmm. And then that was all there was to it. A contract was signed. Nothing had happened in terms of payment. And I need to explain so that people understand. Mm-hmm. It was a design finance construct project. So the government could not be paying any money up front.
Elaborate on what that means for us.
In a design finance construct project, the contractor designs the project and mm-hmm. submits the designs to the ministry. Right. Once the ministry approves the designs, then a costing is put to it based on the extent of works. Once the ministry accepts the terms of works, mm-hmm. then they would negotiate the rates for the work. Once the ministry accepts and the contract is signed, then the contractor begins the work with his own funds, not funds mm-hmm. from the government. The terms of the contract would explain when payments begin. In some of the contracts, the payment would begin after 1 year of completion of the project. Some contracts, you may get it 6 months, you mm-hmm. may get 18 months. It could vary based on the terms of the contract. But until you have signed off on the certificate that says, I accept that this road is completed to the terms stipulated mm-hmm. in the contract, mm-hmm. the government is not obligated to pay any money.
And is that what happened in this case?
That is what happened in
so
this
case. So where does the $2.443 million come from?
The $2.443 million was an advance certificate so that the contractor could draw down from his bank, mm-hmm. not from the Treasury of St. Lucia. Now, and I have a copy of the certificate here, and that is why I say to people, we must be careful when we are going to make statements about people. Because this document is addressed the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Infrastructure, Port Services and Transport. dated 31st May 2012. That is the letter that came from Asphalt and Mining to the ministry.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't the Minister of Infrastructure. I was the Minister of Communications and Works.
Right.
Then you have Interim Payment Certificate number 1, which is the first certificate of approval. This certificate was issued or sent to the ministry on the 13th of February 2012. It is stamped by the ministry as having been approved on the 15th of February 2012. And the signature of the person here is Mr. Jabatis, who was the chief engineer.
Mm-hmm.
That is what, and that is the interim payment certificate for the $2.8 million that is being spoken about. So to say that this happened under my watch is erroneous.
Mm-hmm.
The contract was signed under my watch. And I've heard the minister say that there were certain things illegal about the contract that was signed. I want to ask, if the contract was illegal, why didn't they stop it? Why would they proceed with a contract that is illegal? Because they stopped so many other projects that Asphalt and Mining had interest in, the airport development project, the port, Castries port development with Royal Caribbean.
Mm-hmm.
The Prime Minister made it abundantly clear that he would not be engaging with Asphalt and Mining. There are other letters that I had in my office that was washed away after the Christmas intro.
Mm-hmm.
But I will get them back. It's just a matter of time. Where the contractor, when he made his first request in January, he was told somewhere about January 19th that he had not posted his performance bond yet.
So 2014, they were, you're talking about?
No, 2012.
Okay.
That they would not engage him any further until he had posted his performance bond.
Mm.
So the minister or the Ministry of Infrastructure had every opportunity to deal with this matter.
Mm.
And I have all the interim payment certificates here. Number 5, number 3, number 4, number 2. And you see on number 2, they begin the deduction of the initial payment, not payment, approval, because they didn't make a payment. They made an approval. And they started deducting from payment certificate number 2.
Mm-hmm.
So they were reducing the amount where it should be zeroed by completion of the project.
Okay.
So when the member for Central Castries spoke, he could not have been referring to me, because if he had seen the documents, he would see that this happened, that advance payment was approved in 2012.
Mm-hmm.
I was the minister until November 2011. So how is it possible? And why would people want to label other persons and blame them for what they did? If I had done it, I would have come here and I would have said to everybody, I did that. It was wrong. It was right. That's the reason why I did it. I would have done that. I would never try to pass the blame on somebody else.
Okay, I'm going to ask you to tell me now, based on what you just said, did you or did you not issue or approve contracts for 3 of your brothers?
No, I did not issue contracts to my brothers.
Because the allegations made against you is that you allegedly received, or your brothers received allegedly $700,000 in immediate cleanup works post-Hurricane Tomas, and at least $2.7 million in restoration works, in addition to $47,000 to clear a shed at the George F. L. Charles Airport for upgrade of terminal. That work allegedly never took place.
That is so misleading. And I will, you see, that is the problem that we have in this place.
Mm-hmm.
That people use parliamentary privilege to make these statements, but they will not make these statements out there. They have gone into parliament where you have immunity. You are free to say what you want. But I say what I have to say out there, you know, because I want to be challenged on what I am saying. The issue of the George F.L. Charles, you know when that happened? And that work started through the Ministry of Economic Affairs. When we were having the conference at the Getty, there was an investment conference held at the Getty very early in our term in government, spearheaded by the Ministry of Economic Affairs. Part of the plan was that we were looking at the possibility of the terminal for VG, George Charles Airport, being on the other side, so you could have one single terminal to serve both air passengers and the mega yachts that we were looking at the possibility of bringing into that area. So because the people had to go out there to visit the area, in the old quarry, that place, a project was started to clear up the area so that when the investors were taken on a site visit, they would see the space that was available. That, and to say that no work was done is totally misleading. So the work was done, the clearing was done, and that would have been back in 2007.
But was it awarded to your brother?
Yes, it was done by my brother.
So what about the other projects, the post-Hurricane Thomas cleanup?
There were no contracts issued on the Thomas. All of the works after Thomas was on an hourly basis. Now, to try and single out, I had two brothers that worked during Thomas. Two brothers. I heard the minister mention so many brothers and cousins that I was wondering how many brothers that I have that worked for government.
Okay, we do for a break. Let's take the break, and when we come back, we can continue with your explanation of what actually happened. All right, you're watching Newsmaker Live with me, Kendal Burton, my guest, Mr. Guy Joseph, former Works Minister. When we come back, we'll continue our conversation as the minister defends himself against allegations of impropriety while in office. We'll be right back.